Afternoon. Sorry for the delay. We're back with another broadcasting session of High Spirits Radio. Pirate Radio live from Twitch. Playing 80s music in the soulful, funky variety to lift those spirits. Good afternoon, Tim Pot Gamer. How you been? Yeah, I was just saying, that synth bass is really sick. UK 80s R&B, produced by Carl McIntosh, as I was saying before. Fake Friday, yeah. As far as I'm concerned, it's always a Friday on High Spirits Radio. Hey, Suits! Yeah, it's true. It's hanging out together, right? How's it going, man? I'm eyeing the front door all the time to see if your package arrives or not. Hasn't come yet. Squid. There we go. All right, that's acceptable. The sounds. How's it going? I was just talking earlier about this whole exciting charity thing you've set up. Good stuff, man. How did you take the initiative there? You know the people of the Computing History Museum? Yeah, I'll be playing God of War 3 off stream because my current setup doesn't allow me to stream from PS3. I can stream all my SD consoles except for the N64, and I can stream from the PC at the moment. Right, I gotcha. And so the whole decided to put everything together. Good stuff, man. Good initiative. Yeah, nice. Yeah, I guess as a non-UK citizen, I'm a bit of an outlier in that whole group of streamers. Not to mention that my audience pales in comparison to most of them. But really fun to be a part of it. Quality, not quantity. Definitely. I mean, one thing I'm very happy for is that, you know, my reach is not very great, but the people that do come back every time really make streaming a quality experience. Without the likes of Robert and Timpot Gamer and everything, I might have just called it quits a long time ago already, but it's just too much fun to keep on chatting with everybody. And at least there's a few people that like what I do and keep coming back for it, you know? Yeah, let's do that. Let's all meet up in an arcade club once all of this is over. Fun times. Before the lockdown, me and my kids went to this arcade club in North Amsterdam, which has like 80 cabinets, 80 machines, a lot of classics there. But I've heard that the arcade club is massive. Timpot, wasn't there in London, wasn't there the Heart of Gaming? Is that over with? Yeah. Act like it's a live stream when Ben is playing Ghosts and Ghouls. Ghouls and Ghosts. I haven't been there, Lunar Loony, but in Zoetermeer, close to The Hague, there is also a museum now. They said they're doing alright, they'll just open up after the lockdown again. They'll be fine. Which is run by a guy, Hassan is his name, who I knew from, like, we were vaguely connected when I was working for GamePro magazine. And supposedly that museum contains, or is well on its way to become Europe's largest arcade over the arcade clubs. And I've seen some footage of inside and it looks amazing, so I definitely want to go there as well. Play some Chris Hilsbeck. Jonathan Dunn. Technically, you're part American. Exactly, that's how it works. It's like Walter in The Big Lebowski, right? Someone in his family got... his wife? I think his ex-wife was Jewish, so he was Jewish as well, technically. Shomer Shabbos. He was Jewish when it suited him, yeah. Such a good movie. That's one of those movies that's infinitely rewatchable to me. Just every single bit, every single line of dialogue is just gold in it. You can quote that movie from beginning to end and it's just a good time. New shit has come to life, man. The dude abides. How's that, y'all? Hippity, hippity hop. How's that, y'all? Yeah. But she was, when we hooked up, I was 17 and she was 21, and that's only 4 years of difference, but it might as well have been a world of difference, or it's pretty much a world of difference at that age. Ah, nice, Robert. Long distance relationships. I've been there as well. Amsterdam and Kathmandu. Oh, Yeah, there you go. The lady's over 35. No, I also have never been with someone younger. Yeah, I guess we're just that type of guy. I always found women older than me interesting. Maybe that has to stop somewhere at some point in life, but definitely felt that way when I was younger. My wife has 3 years on me. Yeah, not a big difference anymore in your 30s, definitely. Yeah, yep, here we go. On to Pebbles. Pebbles featured in the Hip Hop Evolution as well, because she is married to L.A. Reid of LaFace Records. So she was instrumental in getting Outkast signed and Goody Mob. Organized Noise, the production team behind Outkast and Goody Mob. Yeah, that song is quite the classic. I don't know if it's quite the classic for all the right reason, but it is a classic nevertheless. I was thinking about that because we did. Hey, K Sub Zero, how's it going? I was thinking about that because of 1994 and Video Wizards, just how much of a big deal MTV was for so long. That was on all the time, especially when I was staying at my girlfriend's place. Just that MTV having that on like all the time. The Beavis and Butthead video game. Happy Fake Friday! Every day is a Fake Friday here on High Spirits Radio. So my kids recently were talking about being the Great Cornolio and needing TP for their bungles. And I was just wondering, like, how do you guys, where do you guys pick up all that stuff? And it's all on TikTok. They all get that stuff on TikTok. And from modern day meme culture. Oh, you guys been playing Streets of Rage 4 together, right? How did that go? Hold on. I'm happy for you guys. You found each other and you found that game. I can't wait to get in on it myself. Everybody's been playing it. But I have to wait, unfortunately. Unless I'm going to double dip. Part of me is thinking about that. Most exciting moment for me in Ninja Gaiden Black was when I saved myself into a corner and had to do the Alma fight with only one small health refill. Two very small health refills and no resources other than that. I think I didn't even have Ninpo magic at that point anymore. So I didn't run rollback saves, so I just had a single save file. And I just had to defeat Alma with those stringent conditions. And I really enjoyed that, because I had to really get to know that boss intimately to be able to beat her without taking much in the way of damage at all. And without having to, you know, without being able to rely on Ninpo. Yeah, that was great. It was a real moment, because then you can't scum your way out of there, out of that fight. You really have to learn that boss or restart the game all over again, which I didn't want to do because I was playing for that deadline as well. Yeah, then you start to develop this intimate knowledge about the boss and its attacks. Yeah, excellent game. I was thinking about returning to it on streams and doing either start a Master Ninja playthrough. I think that's the one after the normal mode, right? Or is there another... maybe there's a hard mode in between there. And yeah, revisit it. At some point, if I don't have any new games to play for Kenarin, so I'll probably do that. Parental advisory, explicit content. Yeah, I know what you mean. I'm just trying to play it dumb. Which is not hard. As odd as the combat still is for me in God of War 2, I do start getting a little bit of a feeling for it now and understanding. Making more use of the circle button for throws definitely helps, but also sort of recognizing enemy animations and roll dodging in time and keeping up the attack pressure right after that. The thing though is that a lot of enemies in God of War games are kind of rote, you know? There's one certain way to deal with them. It's not a very liberating combat system that the game has. I'm starting to click with it slowly. It's just different. It's not necessarily bad. It's just different. Oh, hold up. I'm not streaming on Kenarin's channel tomorrow. I haven't put the announcement out for that yet, but because of the whole charity stream that I'm participating in, I don't want to cross streams with the charity efforts. So I'm taking a step back tomorrow night. Yeah, have a great one as well. But I'll be on for 2 hours on this channel on Sunday. Banger incoming. Brace yourselves. What is this, romance? We need the banging beats. And here's one. Here we go. FM synth drum machines. How does this sound to you? Thank you. Hasta la vista, baby. This came out before Terminator 2, right? Yeah, it did. Definitely. So this album is produced by André Simon, who was in Prince's touring band before the revolution. Just had to look that up. I get really interested now who produced all this stuff. The majority of it was all like Jam and Lewis. Yeah, I can definitely sense that the producer of this album used to work with Prince. Sounds like something that could come from that stable. We've got a Bad Education TV in the house. Evil Ninja Phil. Philip Doyle. Yeah, right? Nice. Kids out of the way. Yeah. I think Rob let his kids listen to this stream once. But He got him out before the funk became too heavy. He got him out safe. Yeah. Some diehard cheese rollers will try to break the curfew. I'm gonna roll that cheese down that hill, damn it. Yeah, so I can't find an English Wikipedia entry on it. It's actually not eel whipping, but it was eel pulling. So people would there would be a live eel hung over a canal on a rope, and people would have to, you know, go into their little boats under that eel and try to pull it off, but the government called it cruel entertainment, so they banned it. It was deemed cruel to animals. So it spawned a people's revolt in 1886 in Amsterdam. Big riots because the police banned the eel pulling. So they call that the eel riots. There's some pictures of it as well. I'll just put the Dutch Wikipedia entry in here. You can pull it through your translation engine. Local Dutch news of 1886. Local Dutch news. I don't think we can tie, realistically, we can't tie any video game to that date. The eel pulling riots. Yeah. Should actually make a video game about eel pulling. Since we can't have that noble time-honored tradition anymore, since it's banned since the late 1800s, we should just be able to relive it in video game form, right? Eel!